The complainants in the Andrew Bolt defamation case say although the judge could have been more severe, they're happy with today's federal court decision to impose apology notices on the Herald and Weekly Times.
We've slowly put it behind us. It's a good outcome. And I'm sure Pat Etock, who couldn't be present today, will be pleased with the judge's final orders.
Justice Bromberg ordered the notice be published twice alongside Bolt's columns in the next fortnight to provide a public record of the court's findings and help redress the harm done by the columns.
It was an important principle to fight for. I took the position that rather than compensation, I was looking at vindication for complaint that we made against Bolt. I think it would be foolhardy of the Herald and Weekly Times and Bolt to appeal on this judgment.
We're very pleased with the outcome, we look forward to living normal lives as proud Aboriginal people, brought up to be proud of our identity and use it to walk tall wherever we choose to go in life.
There still may be individuals that may seek a more personal apology from Bolt.
Newspaper ordered to correct Bolt's mistakes. Andrew Bolt's newspaper, Melbourne Herald Sun, has been ordered to publish a corrective notice after the federal court found that two of Bolt's columns attacking fair-skinned Aboriginals in 2009 breached the Racial Discrimination Act. Justice Mordecai Bromberg ordered the notice be published twice alongside Bolt's columns in the next fortnight to provide a public record of the court's findings and help redress the harm done by the columns. The court found Bolt had wrongly accused a number of fair-skinned Australians of being motivated by career opportunities or political activism to falsely identify as Aboriginals. Bolt's articles were published in 2009, were headlined "It's So Hip to Be Black" and "White Fellas in the Black." Justice Bromberg declared the columns were reasonably likely to offend, insult, humiliate or intimidate some Aboriginal persons of mixed descent. Lawyers for Bolt and his newspapers had admitted even before the trial began that 9 of the fair-skinned Aboriginals Bolt named and attacked in his columns had been raised from childhood to identify as Aboriginal. The central issue at the trial was whether the columns were protected by the free speech provisions of the Racial Discrimination Act. Justice Bromberg found that they were not because of Bolt's many errors and his inflammatory language he used in attacking these Aboriginals. The judge refused to force Bolt and the Herald Sun to apologise or to strip the columns from the paper's archives and website. He did order that they not be republished. In making his orders this morning, Justice Bromberg emphasised his findings did not in any way restrain the publication of other articles dealing with the same subject. Bolt did not make an appearance at the ruling today. One of the 9 Aboriginals who took action against Bolt, Graham Atkinson, told the AAP the corrective notice was a good outcome. I think it's important that Bolt is made accountable, and if that's a way of doing it, then I think that will be an important pressure placed on the publisher, Herald and Weekly Times, and also Andrew Bolt, he said outside court. But Mr. Atkinson said it was disappointing the group did not get an apology from Bolt himself, and some members of the group felt that was an imperative. Watch this space, I guess. There may be individuals that will pursue that avenue. I can't speak for them, Mr. Atkinson said. He also said that the group had fire left in the belly if Bolt and the Herald and Weekly Times decided to appeal against the ruling. Mr. Atkinson's brother, Wayne Atkinson, suggested Bolt's decision not to offer an apology could weigh on him forever. We're quite happy with the outcome, but for me personally, yes, I think we need an apology. For an apology is still there. It will sit in the conscience of those people forever, probably. I'll try and see if I can find. I don't think I've ever actually read the original articles. I will try and look for them and maybe post them up so everyone can decide for themselves what they think of what Bolt has said. But by the sounds of it, it was what he said in those articles was straight out racist. And I expect nothing less from a conservative.